Thank you very much, Mr. Chairman. Special invited guests. It's very challenging to be here this afternoon, right? Let me explain why, right? As PRO of the South Central Zone of Tuku, I'm also responsible for the running of Calypso Showcase, which is the biggest Calypso tent in the country right now. And I'm not saying that by any wild boast, but we are the only tent that is currently filling our doors nightly, right? So that's part of the reason why it's going to be so challenging for me to speak to you this evening, because after performing last night, we have to perform again and put forth tonight. But also for those creative people who also engage in academic pursuits, you would know that the creative process really involves the right hemisphere of the brain, right? And it's very challenging to use both of them at the same time or close afterwards, right? So I'm going to challenge myself this afternoon to do that, both in terms of being in the middle of the performance season and to do it right here this evening in front of you, alright? There's an ancient saying that in every crisis there's an opportunity. You know, and many of us would acknowledge that presently in our society, if we haven't yet reached crisis, we're not very far from it in quite a number of areas. Sometimes the opportunity is manifested not just in the things that we do, but how we look at the approaches that we use, you know, and unless we have a clear understanding of what is really in front of us, you know, decision making could very well lead to failure once again. So, in my humble opinion, we find ourselves in a situation where we have opportunities to look at what we have been doing and what we continue to do differently, okay? I want to address a very important concern of the national community right now, where the arts industry is concerned, you know, and particularly as a representative of the Calypsonians organization, we have a lot of people that are saying, you know, well, it's time for government to stop giving handouts, handouts to the arts community. So I want to address the issue of handouts. In Tuko, we have just over 600 Calypsonians, and not all of them are practicing. And outside of Tuko, we probably have a similar amount of Calypsonians and soca artists who are engaged in the music industry. So let's assume that in all we have about, let's say about 600 people who actually produce music, right, during that period from October, November to the calendar period. In addition to that, we also have a number of our young school children who also perform. And let's look at the process, because as a music producer, I am at almost the beginning part of the whole process. It costs approximately $500 to do a demo. Now, a demo is that basic piece of music that an artist would use when they go to perform, whether it's to audition or whether they go to perform at an event, right? And that demo it is not the full production of the music, so it's not something that you can take to the radio station, right? So, you have, in my estimation, during that period, including the adults and the children, approximately 1,000 people investing $500 each just to get a piece of music for them to perform. So we start off with the Calypsonians, young and old, investing from our own pockets approximately $500,000, which would go towards somebody who operates a studio, taking care of him, herself, and the family, to the background vocalist who would go to the studio to perform background tasks for this artist, being able to get supplemental income in some cases for themselves and their family. For musicians, the guitarists, the horn men, etc., that will earn an income. I don't know if you see where I'm going, right? So that even before the artist hits the stage, that artist has already contributed to the internal economy of the country. And out of that 1,000 people, about 200 of them might decide to go full production. In other words, you go to the studio and you pay approximately $7,000 or $8,000 to produce a piece of music that you hope the music, the radio stations will play. And I'm talking about in the land of Calypso. So let's estimate 200 people investing $7,000, and we're talking about, let me get my mathematics correct, we're talking about just over $1 million already invested. And when we add that to what is invested by the artist just to do a demo, we're talking about somewhere in the region of $2 million that the artists have already put into the local economy. All right? I'm saying this because, you see, we have to change our mindset. When the artists do what they do, and when we include the mask makers, the people who engage in PAN, that invites people to come to the country so that we have foreign exchange coming into the country. And I heard our hard-working chairman speak about just over $1 billion that comes into the country every year. And from the figures that I have received, it is closer to about $6 or $7 billion when you look at the money that is earned by the hotels and the airlines, etc., etc. So when our government invests, let's say,